Do you ever wonder where the oxygen in the air you breathe comes from? In this science snack, I'm going to show you how to actually see and measure the oxygen produced by a leaf during photosynthesis. Here's what you'll need: spinach or ivy leaves, baking soda, also known as sodium bicarbonate, a gram scale, water, liquid dish soap, a bottle, a soda straw or a hole punch, a 10 milliliter syringe without the needle, a clear plastic cup or beaker that can hold about a cup of water, an incandescent or 100 watt equivalent light bulb in a fixture, preferably with a clamp,
a ring stand or something else to clamp your light on,
a timer, paper and pencil to record your results, foil.
First thing I'm going to do is make a buffer to carry out this reaction in. This buffer is going to be 0.1% baking soda, that's weight to volume. So I'm going to measure out 0.5 grams of baking soda using my scale, and I'm going to put it in 500 milliliters, it's about 2 cups of water. And I'm going to just put the cap on and dissolve the baking soda in the water. This buffer needs one more thing, which is a little bit of dish soap. The dish soap helps the baking soda get past the water repellent surface of the leaf. And I'm going to mix that in, but I'm going to be very gentle because I don't want to create too many bubbles in my buffer. The next thing I'm going to do is make my leaf discs. So I'm going to use spinach leaves. And I covered them with tin foil because it's a good idea to keep them in the dark until you're about ready to do your experiment. I'm going to punch holes of spinach leaves and put them inside this syringe. So the first thing I'll do is remove the plunger from the syringe. And I'll punch about 10 holes using the end of a straw out of the spinach leaves. If you're using ivy, it's better to use a hole punch since the leaves are a little bit tougher. To get these spinach leaf discs into the syringe, I'll just blow really gently. I'm going to tap the leaves down to the bottom of the syringe so they're not stuck on the sides, and replace the plunger. And push it almost all the way in, being careful not to smush the leaves. I'm going to add some buffer to this cup. The cup is clear, which is important, and I'm going to pour carefully, again trying to avoid too many bubbles in my cup. Then I'm going to draw up a few milliliters of my buffer into my syringe with the leaf discs. So my leaf discs are floating right at the top of the liquid in the syringe. This is because there's actually air inside of leaves in the interstitial spaces, which means between the cells. I want my leaf discs to sink, so I need to remove the air. I'm going to do that by applying a light vacuum. So the first thing I'll do is I'm going to depress the plunger just to remove most of the air from the syringe. I'm going to put my thumb over the tip of the syringe to make a good seal. And then I'm going to pull gently on the plunger. And when I do that, I see little bubbles coming out of my leaf discs. I'm going to pull back a few mils and then release. I'll tap a couple of times to dislodge any bubbles. And the leaf disc should start to sink. They haven't sunk yet though, so I'm going to do this a couple of more times. Again, applying a gentle vacuum and then releasing the plunger. And vacuum and release. So most of the leaf discs are settled to the bottom. I've sucked out enough air so that they sink to the bottom. You might have to do this a few times, apply the vacuum and then release. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put my leaf discs into this cup of buffer. So to do that, I want to make sure that I pull the plunger out slowly directly over the cup so that they just spill into the cup. So I've given these leaf discs carbon in the water in the form of baking soda. So now I'm going to give them energy from this light bulb in the form of light. I'm going to turn on the light, and start this timer so that I can tell when my leaf discs start to do something interesting. And I notice that there are tiny bubbles accumulating on the surface of the discs and around the edges. Those bubbles are actually oxygen that the leaf discs are producing as they photosynthesize. I'm keeping note of when the leaf discs start floating. My first leaf disc started floating about 45 seconds into my experiment. And now, about a minute and a half later, I have three leaf discs floating. So by 5 minutes, all of my discs are floating. This might take your discs longer or shorter depending on your leaves and your light source. Once all my discs are floating, I'm going to do one more experiment. I'm going to cover them with foil. You could just also put them in a dark cabinet. But basically, we want to remove the light source. I'm going to leave these alone for a few minutes and come back and check on them later. So I left my leaf discs in the dark for about half an hour. I'm going to check on them now. And most of them have sunk to the bottom of the cup. They stopped floating in the dark. So in this experiment, you've given your leaf discs everything that they need to do photosynthesis. You've given them some carbon dissolved in the water in the form of baking soda. You've given them light from your light bulb, and you've given them plenty of water. They're going to use these materials to make glucose or sugar. And as a byproduct, they're making the tiny bubbles of oxygen gas that you observe gathering around the edges. You can actually use this experiment as an indirect measurement of the net rate of oxygen production and thus of photosynthesis. The faster the discs float to the top, the more oxygen must be being produced, and thus the more photosynthesis must be happening. So notice that I said you're measuring the net rate of oxygen production and photosynthesis. Plants make sugar and oxygen, but they also use it, just like us. Animals, like us, do basically the reverse reaction of photosynthesis. We break down sugar to produce energy, and as a byproduct, carbon dioxide. And this reaction requires the oxygen that we breathe. This is called cellular respiration. Plants also do cellular respiration. They make sugar and they use sugar. So as they're producing sugar and oxygen, they're also consuming it. So the bubbles that you see represent the net oxygen, the oxygen that the leaves make minus the oxygen that they're using. When you cover the cup with foil or put it in the dark, you're removing the light energy that the leaf uses for photosynthesis. So it can't make sugar and oxygen anymore, but it's still using sugar and oxygen, doing cellular respiration. That's why the leaves in the dark will eventually sink. The leaves will use up the oxygen in the tiny bubbles that they made, and without the bubbles, they'll sink to the bottom of the cup. It's very easy to manipulate variables in this experiment to figure out what affects the rate of photosynthesis. You can add more or less baking soda, use different light sources, or even use gel filters to change the wavelength of the light that's hitting the leaves. If you keep a record of how quickly the leaves float under different conditions, you'll be able to figure out how these different conditions affect the rate of net photosynthesis.